Welcome to a new video. My name is Amsterdam Comic Geek, and this is an illustration by the wonderful, talented Todd McFarlane. It's a Spider-Man illustration from his Spider-Man days in the late 80s, and it's the Dutch edition of Amazing Spider-Man 316. Now, a while ago, McFarlane posted this image, at least the original of it, on his Instagram account, and I thought this was a fascinating image. First of all, you can clearly see how wonderful his art style was back in the day and how spectacularly he drew Spider-Man. But the reason I wanted to show you this image is because of the background. As you can see, it looks like McFarlane uses some kind of photo material reference, or maybe he edited a photo in the background so it didn't have to draw New York. And this has always fascinated me, this technique, and I'm not really sure what's going on. So I thought I'll make this short video so maybe you guys know how this technique works. I asked McFarlane on Instagram and he hasn't replied yet. You can hardly blame the guy for that, because he gets a lot of comments on his work and great reactions, and he's a busy guy, but I'm curious about it. So maybe you guys know how Todd McFarlane did this. Look here, for instance, it's a little bit faded in the background, and it's clearly a photograph, but I'm not really sure how he did it. Now, on the previous page, he uses a similar technique of Spider-Man web swinging, and then above New York, and this is also clearly a photograph edited in the background. At least I think it's edited in the background. I also have the American version of this comic, and I'll show you that in a second. But I thought I'll show you the Dutch version, because this paper doesn't reflect so much with the lights I'm using. So you can clearly see the picture. You can see the picture better this way. Because this is a technique Todd McFarlane used a lot. Now, this is the Birth of Venom trade paperback with the cover of 316, Amazing Spider-Man 316 recolored. And in Amazing Spider-Man 300, at the end, and it's the first time McFarlane draws Spider-Man in his classic costume, he also uses this same technique. And I think this is the first time I've seen him do it. But I'm not... maybe he used it in other comics he drew before he made Spider-Man. I'm not sure. The legend begins anew. But this is the one I remember most clearly. And as you can see, it also looks like a photograph used in the background. Also, sadly, this image is reprinted a lot, of course, because Spider-Man 300, which is the introduction of Venom, is reprinted a lot. And it's always, the coloring is always wrong. The spider on his back is always in a different color. This time it's blue, but I believe originally it was green or something. I don't know, something always goes off with the coloring, which is sad because it's a great, great splash page. I really like it. And I also like the technique of the photograph technique, because it really makes New York look real, because it's a real photograph, of course. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you know what kind of technique is used, please leave a message in the comments. And if you like the videos I make, please subscribe and like the video. And I'll catch you guys later. Cheers.